Hi everybody, welcome to the Hair Loss Show. I'm Dr. Russell Knudsen.
I'm Dr. Vikram Jayaprakash. Good to see you, Russell.
Thank you, Vikram.
Okay, so today's episode we're going to talk, technology, right? So we've talked a lot about hair transplants, but one of the sort of non-surgical innovations in the field that's sort of becoming more popular over the last couple of years is what we call transepidermal delivery systems,
yes.
Where we are now able to take medication or molecules or treatments and then try and push them through the skin to increase the efficacy of those treatments. And there are a variety of different models on the market, and they work in different ways.
I guess the thing I'd like to start with is to make people understand that when we apply things topically to the scalp, we're not applying it to the hair, right? Because the hair is a piece of rope that sits on the scalp. The critical thing, if we're going to manage and treat people, is to get it to go through the skin. Now, the epidermis is the outer part of the skin. So when we say transepidermal, we're trying to get the medicine from the or the treatment from the outside the skin through the skin layer to be absorbed into the bloodstream underneath and to get to the hair follicle that way, or just because it gets to the hair follicle. So the critical thing about that is to think that skin's natural role in life is as a barrier to protect us from the outside environment. So we're trying to cross the barrier, and that's the secret. And there are different technologies to do it. So one of the technologies is to use microneedling.
Correct. Okay. Yes, microneedling is what it does. Is it creates these little channels that the needle actually creates, and through that you can apply a medication on top of the skin, and it will absorb through that. It will go into those little pores, and the absorption will be increased. Just to quickly recap, what you're saying is that there's the aspect of the, if we just draw it, there's essentially two functions really that we need to consider. If you've got the skin, you've got the sort of stratum corneum, the thick layer above the top of the skin, but also it's a function of the molecule as well.
The size of the molecule.
So what we need to do is, because if the molecule is too big, then no matter how thin this the skin is, it's still not going to penetrate. And vice versa, even if you've got the smallest molecule, if you've got the thickest of skin, so for example, the palms of your hands, the soles of your feet, which traditionally are very thick, have very thick layers, then you're not going to get absorption through that as well. So it's, how do we optimize?
Well, the technology, there's been a technology developing for a long time about using tiny little soap bubbles,
yes,
right, to actually reduce the size of things and allow them to penetrate through the skin. But also the newer technologies these days are about disrupting the barrier, which microneedling is one example. And another example is using ultrasound.
Yes.
So there are now things that you can apply topically, and then you use an ultrasound on top of it, to drive things through the scalp and get a higher absorption through there. So this is what we're talking about when we talk about transepidermal. How do we do it? The attraction of doing things topically is to reduce the absorption into the rest of the body and therefore reduce the risk of side effects. And so it's clearly something that appeals to patients from that perspective. That's on the plus side. On the negative side is a lot of these things have to be done in clinic.
Of course.
Rather than at home, which means that A, you've got to go to the clinic, B, there's going to be cost involved going to the clinic. But this is the cost-benefit analysis as to what your fear is of doing it. Laser, for example, when we use red light lasers, we have home use devices, mm-hmm. either combs or caps. Doesn't have to be done in the clinic, but if you're talking about things like mesotherapy injecting or PRP injecting, or you're talking about ultrasound-driven technology to get to disrupt the epidermal barrier, these are things that have to be done in clinic.
Yeah, so they're just methods by which we can get whatever molecule or medication that we're looking at, sort of getting to the deeper level, just the ability to access that.
And it's something you have to do every day. One of the objections we get from patients is, what do you mean I have to take something every day?
Yes.
And then when we say to them, no, well, you can do this every 1 month or every 2 months or every 3 months or every 6 months, depending on what the technology is and what the result is, that sometimes is very appealing. And at the end of the day, it doesn't matter what you or I recommend to the patient.
Yeah.
It's whether they're willing to use it,
correct,
which is what we call compliance. And so one of the things that is critical when we're having discussions with our patients is working out what they're prepared to do and what they're prepared to commit to because it doesn't matter what we think is going to work best for them if they won't use it.
Yes. So it's all fair and well to come in for a consultation and go, oh, look, I'm really enthusiastic. I'll just do one treatment, right? Well, that's probably not going to reap the kind of rewards that you're hoping that it will do. Whereas doing something topically at home on a daily basis is probably going to be more effective. But if you can come in, and these devices have been shown to have a great deal of benefit, then what you're going to do is you're going to increase the penetration of some of these medications. You can be able to bypass the liver in the use of some of these things. You can basically get a higher effect and not have to do it as frequently.
And at a lower dose.
Yes.
So if you've got better skin penetration through the barrier, then you can use a smaller dose of whatever the therapy is, because you're getting a better absorption through the skin and there, a better level within the hair tissue, which is where you want it to be.
Yeah.
So that you, you know, by putting less in, you run less of a side effect.
So things that we can do with that, we can do you know, things like peptides, exosomes can also be done through these transepidermal delivery systems, obviously finasteride. And there's a bit of a contentious issue about deuterosteride.
Yeah, it still is a problem molecule for us, yeah, in the sense topically it's such a big molecule, it's hard to get it through the skin.
Yeah.
And so I still think that to use it topically will still at this point in time requires an injection. We don't have good evidence that we can get it in any other way.
Yeah, but again, it's a painless device, doesn't hurt at all.
Correct.
And can be done very quickly. They call it a lunchtime procedure because you can essentially come in, quickly get it done and return back to work. There's very little downtime or no downtime.
Obviously, if you live a long way away from the clinic, this is not going to be something that's going to be easy.
Yeah.
You know, we do understand the limitations of it, and not all clinics are going to offer the therapies because, you know, the machinery is significant, and only a number of, you know, a small number of clinics are going to have it. But it's a good option for people that want to go down that path.
Perfect. So hope you found that useful. That's transepidermal delivery systems. There's, you know, multiple different machines on the market. Feel free to do your research, find out, you know, a clinic near you that is able to offer that service. Thanks again for watching. We look forward to seeing you on the next episode.
And keep liking and subscribing. Thank you very much, everyone.